if you poke the bear enough, the bear is going to poke back. What is up, everybody? Chaos here, and it seems like I make this video once a year, and it's almost like a bulletin, if you will, a how to avoid this, or an alert, something of that manner. It's common knowledge, but when you get into this world of Call of Duty content creation and Call of Duty leaks and the hype and everything going on and people want to know before they're supposed to know, you get caught up in it. And I've been there. I understand that fully. What is up, everybody? Hopefully you're having a great day. It's actually Valentine's Day while I'm recording this, so I hope you have a happy Valentine's. I hope you get to spend it with the ones you love. And if you stick around towards the end of the video, I have something really cool to announce to you guys that you may want to be part of, so stick around. So, everybody knows, Modern Warfare, Warzone, Battle Royale, leaks and rumors flying everywhere, literally flying everywhere, leaked gameplay going up on YouTube, all kinds of files being found, people being shoved into Warzone lobbies and not even meaning to. And actually, I think I saw somebody get shoved in one and then he got suspended on his Modern Warfare account, which is absolutely crazy. They need to fix that. I mean, if that's not their fault, but it's getting crazy to the point where we have to pay respects to the gaming revolution. I mean, like I said, you poke the bear enough and it's going to poke back. And Activision is a very, very big bear, especially in terms of their legal department, and when they want to protect their IP or their assets or their content. If they feel threatened, let's just put it this way. You don't want to make Activision feel threatened. Now, this is kind of a disclaimer for all of you. It's a warning. If you do YouTube at all, and we talk about this every single year, especially now, it's February. That means we are going to start getting teases and leaks and little bits of information for COD 2020, which is super polarizing because we don't know what it's going to be. We think it's going to be Black Ops 5. We think it's going to be a Black Ops reboot. Treyarch supposedly in charge. Sledgehammer supposedly got kicked back as a support role and they're working on COD 2021. It's going to be a polarizing year. And with that come leaks and rumors and people that push that boundary of what they can get away with. I'm here to tell you, and it's kind of at the gaming revolution's expense, but be careful. If you have any social media accounts that you value, if you have a YouTube channel that you value at all, you have to understand the rules, the guidelines, the gray area that you can walk and where you can't walk when it comes to leaks and rumors. I cover leaks and rumors all the time, and some of you may say, well, you're a hypocrite, you cover leaks and rumors, you're right. But there's a way to do it, and there is a way not to do it. And the gaming revolution pushed it to the point where he crossed that line. So if you guys don't know, gaming revolution, probably the biggest leaker in Call of Duty history. I say that. The guy's been leaking for over a year. Most everything he leaks ends up coming true or to fruition at some point because he has legit inside sources somewhere in Activision or Infinity Ward or Treyarch. He does. He's proved that, okay? And he pushes and he leaks and he throws all the information out there. And yesterday, he put up actual leaked gameplay of the Modern Warfare Warzone training thing, I think it was. I think it was like a training spot that you go into, training grounds. It wasn't actually on the map. It wasn't you dropping into said Battle Royale, but it was the kind of the tutorial, if you will, on how to train you to get ready. And he tweeted out he didn't think he would get a strike for it because it was Activision's mistake, and why would they punish people for their mistake? And that is where he was sorely wrong, because regardless if it's their mistake and they put this in the files and people are getting into Warzone, it's still their IP. They still own it 100% and they still reserve the right to absolutely can your channel or your videos or your Twitter account or your Instagram if they deem you are threatening their position or their IP in any way. Well, I would say if there's a big board up in an Activision room or somewhere, the gaming revolution's probably up there as a level 5 threat, because he leaks stuff. I mean, he puts stuff out there that they probably don't want to be out there. I think he's actually gone back and forth with a couple employees on Twitter in the past, and he continues to put it out there. But yesterday, he went too far. He put the gameplay out there. He posted that he was going to be putting the gameplay out there. And then the video got struck, which is not a big shock. I even replied to him after it got struck and I said, what were you expecting? This isn't your first go around. You knew this was going to happen. You have to know this is going to happen. If they don't want you to see it, you don't put it. And there's some rules you can go by, okay? If you want to cover leaks and rumors, you need to kind of feel the pulse of what you're putting. Like, there's times where I'll make a video and I'll put absolutely no pictures. I'll verbally talk about it, I'll reference it, or something of that manner, but I don't put anything out there because it's hot, you know? And it, like the Warzone menu that got leaked and the gameplay, obviously, that's hot right now. That's super, you don't want to touch it. It's kryptonite, okay? And you can tell that. You can kind of tell the pulse of that. You can follow Charlie Intel. More than likely, if they've put it on their website and it hasn't been taken down, then maybe you can put it up, but you're still going to need to be careful because I would say they're a legitimized news outlet and maybe they could get away with a little more. The point is, you are taking a chance if you put leaked material on the internet. Now, a rule of thumb, you can verbally talk about whatever you want to. Anything. You can speculate until you're blue in the face. They will not strike you. There's nothing they can strike you for if it's your thoughts and comments in your voice. Okay, over some regular gameplay or whatever. You can do that all day long. I do that a lot. Maybe if something circled the internet enough and you feel that it's okay picture-wise or something, you could get away with it. But when you start seeing red flags and you start seeing videos go down or you start seeing pictures pulled off of Reddit, there's a reason for that. They're not going to let people get away with it. And that's what happened to the gaming revolution, even to the point where Twitter suspended his account. Not just on YouTube. He's got the strike on YouTube. I haven't even checked his YouTube channel. I don't know if his YouTube channel actually got taken down or if it was just that one copyright strike. But his Twitter account, as of the making of this video, is gone. You can't do anything on it. Which is, I mean, some people say it's just a Twitter account. Well, that was his main voice. His voice has been snuffed out at the moment when it comes to that because of the stuff that he's put up. He pushed and pushed and pushed, and they got to a point where they said, you know what? We're going to do this on our terms. If there is a battle royale coming, we're going to launch it the way we want to, and we're going to go on our roadmap for all the millions of dollars we put into it, and this guy isn't going to deter us anymore. And that's kind of where they're at. So I guess the point of the video is this. There are always going to be leaks and rumors. There's websites that are built upon this. There are leakers out there that do it, but they also do it in the right way. Take for instance, Shinobi. Shinobi leaks, but a lot of the stuff he leaks, it is literally just text. He will verbally or textually put something out on Twitter or wherever talking about the leaks. That's his voice. That's him talking about. There's nothing you can suspend there. There's nothing you can really attack there in forms of pictures or gameplay or anything like that. It's when you cross that line and you take actual gameplay of something they don't want people to see, or pictures or title menus or anything like that. There's a lot of stuff out there now. All the vehicles have been leaked. I mean, Trios is being talked about. All kinds of stuff. And you can cover that. I think they're okay with that and it builds the hype. But when you start putting their intellectual property out there that they don't want people to see yet, that's it. You poked a very, very big bear and the bear ate you. And that's kind of where we're at. So my message to you is this. If you do YouTube, if you have a big YouTube channel, if you have a small YouTube channel, it doesn't matter. If you're on Twitter and you're active in the Call of Duty community, heck, if you're on Reddit, you need to be careful with what you post if you value those platforms. If you don't care, do what you want to do. But if you value them at all and it's something you want to keep and build and have as part of whatever you're doing, don't be shocked. Don't be surprised if you go poke the bear like that and you end up losing the platform because you're dealing with entities that are way beyond your means. I mean, we're talking about billion-dollar corporations that have teams of lawyers and strategists and everything to protect their assets. Just food for thought, and that's where we're at. Yes, it is hot. Modern Warfare, Warzone, Battle Royale. Obviously, it's real in a sense. It's probably coming. Classified menu on there. I mean, all arrows point to this happening, which has everybody excited, including myself. I'll be covering it the best I can for you guys. But There's a way to do it, and then there's a way to not do it. Now, I told you if you stuck around to the end of the video, I was going to do something special. I want to do a dual com with an actual subscriber. Somebody that doesn't have a YouTube channel, or maybe a small, super small YouTube channel, and kind of bring them on and do a dual com. Not a dual com about, hey, what do you do for a living? Or, hey, what's your favorite food? I want to like bring them on an actual video I'm doing, a topic-driven video, Advanced Warfare 2, World at War 2, COD 2020, something that I would do anyway, but bring on a partner for a video. I thought that would be cool. So in the comment section, you let me know, why should I pick you to come on and do a dual com with me on my channel? If you guys enjoyed the video, drop a like. Like I said, I will keep you guys covered to the best of my ability. And pour a little out. RIP, the gaming revolution at the moment. We'll see if he is able to bounce back and come back. And if you guys get anything from G2A.com, make sure to use promo code CHAOS. You don't get a discount. You get actual cash back. Link is in the description. I'll see you soon.